Hey Sunrise, it's Andrew here with your small group questions for this week as we close out our series on gospel culture. So as we think back over the last 4 weeks, what are some of the things that have stood out when we talked about gospel culture? What does gospel culture look like to you now in light of the last 4 weeks of sermons, the four texts that we have walked through? And then as you think about those ideas of gospel culture, what then is our responsibilities as believers in the local church in bringing these things about? What roles do we play in producing gospel culture here? So again, just thinking through some of the different works that are some of the different texts that we've worked through. What are some of those application points that really stand out to you and bring this to fruition that helps us live out this faith well? Specifically, as we work here in John Chapter 13, verses 31 to 35, we have Jesus's encouragement to the disciples, ultimately ending with that phrase, "They will know that you are my disciples by how you love one another," that closing to this text. But it all highlights this reality that as believers, we are called to love one another as Christ has loved us. And so this text sets this foundation for living out the faith for a world to see. So the gospel culture fuels gospel mission. It fuels how the gospel is seen around us. And so how does John 13 help us see this reality of God's love for us? How do we see Christ's love for us displayed in this text? What are some of the things that stand out? How does Jesus love his disciples? And then from that, how do we love each other? So how do these things fit together? And so we work through these ideas. How is that love displayed to an unbelieving world? What is it about that love that Christ is discussing that an unbelieving world would find amazing, that would find different, that that's something only found in those who believe the gospel, who are disciples of Christ? What is it about that love that would stand out? And then, of course, how often do we do it? What are some of the reasons why we don't do it well? And then what are some of the encouragements for us to do it well, especially in light of the sermon on Sunday? And again, the whole avenue that we've been working through about living out the gospel is more than knowing it. It's about experiencing it and living it one to another. That knowledge becomes reality. And so this is really where we've gone over the last 4 weeks. So I hope that you'll spend some time in the text, again, John 13, 31 to 35, but also in small groups as an opportunity to put some of these things in action, having these conversations, then growing not only in the group on during the midweek, but throughout the week. Hope that you'll spend a lot of time in God's word, in prayer, and then again, life together. Can't wait to worship you guys on Sunday. See you soon.